Hi, Gentoo. Welcome to Sunday service. Today is a very special day. We gather together through Zoom and have service together with your teachers. This is amazing. Then hopefully we will see you guys physically at the church in JCJC at Gentoo Room. But today, God allow us to have service together in online. Let's praise God and worship God with all our hearts. Before we begin, our teacher, any teacher, who is my wife, and she's gonna open us in prayer. Let's pray together.
Let's pray and open our worship. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for giving us another day to worship you, and thank you so much for giving us this online worship so we could still stay at home and worship you. God, we're not just watching video clips, but we want to worship you and glorify you through prayer, through offering, through preaching, and through the praising time. We know that you are glorified. God, some of us are not feeling good emotionally and spiritually and physically. God, put your hands upon them so that they would just feel the joy and peace in their heart. God, let the kids know that you are there with them all the time, and you know better than I do and they do and the parents do. God, please receive our worship, and please give us and please let us experience the true joy of worship so that we would just glorify you through this time. I pray in Jesus' name, amen.
Gemma
the week. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The question for today is, do you know fairy tale?
I don't know.
No.
I think it was something about boat. Like
boat?
And the water.
What's your name? Disciples?
What's the question?
What did Jesus say to Simon Peter as he got out of the boat?
Got into the boat.
Oh. Jesus said,
hurry up. Let's catch the fish.
Are you hungry?
Well, let's find out. Should we pick someone?
All right.
Noah
Choi. Ah, Noah. Noah, 축하해. Please send me your answer. And we'll give you some gift. Mm-hmm. Alright, everyone, we'll see you next week.
Bye! Bye.
seeking mercy and grace, I come to the cross where you died in my place. Out of my weakness and into your strength, Jesus, I come to the cross. Your arms are open, you call me by name. You welcome this child that was lost. You pay the price for my guilt and my shame. Jesus, I come. Jesus, I come. Jesus, I come to the
Gem 2, welcome to Sunday service. I hope you guys had a blessing week this week. No special announcement today other than, you know, we started doing Zoom meetings. So on the second week of the month, we are going to have small group like we did a couple weeks ago. And today, we are also having Zoom meeting with everybody. So just mark that on your calendar. Just remind yourself on the second week, and then on the fourth week, we are having meetings, okay? Have a great service today.
Dear God, thank you for giving us this beautiful Lord's Day to worship you and learn more about you. We have prepared the offering to give to you, for you are so good to us. Please use this offering to build your kingdom on earth. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Gem 2, this is the message time, but today we invited a special guest for you guys. Pastor Hannah, she will share gospel with you guys. Please listen carefully, okay? You guys ready? Set, go!
Thank you, Pastor David and Gem 2 for inviting me to Gem 2 Sunday morning to share the word of God. I really, really miss you guys so, so much. Let's open up our Bible to Luke chapter 5. We're going to read from verses 7 to 11. Luke chapter 5, verses 7 to 11. All right, are you guys ready? Let's read it together in one voice. So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats so full that they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, "Go away from me, Lord. I am a sinful man." For he and his companions were astonished at the catch of fish they had taken. And so were James and John, the sons of Zebedee, Simon's partners. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Don't be afraid. From now on, you will fish for people." So they pulled their boats up on shore, left everything, and followed him. Amen. Amen. So as you guys can see, we see Jesus, and we see Simon Peter, and we see Simon Peter's brother name, Andrew, and their partners, the other fishermen. See, the story goes, Simon Peter and Andrew, these two brothers, went out to the sea to catch for fish. Now, there were fishermen. Their job was to catch fish to make money and to also eat for themselves. Being a fisherman was a good job. But that day, when they went out to catch the fish, for some reason, they were not able to catch a fish. Not even one. So finally, they came back with empty-handed, and they were washing their nets. They were cleaning. But Jesus saw what was going on. Jesus told Simon Peter and Andrew, the brothers, to get on the boat and sail to deeper part of the sea so that they could catch fish. Did they complain? "But Jesus, we already went out trying to catch for fish, but we couldn't." Did they say that? No, they did not complain. They simply followed Jesus' command. And so they got into the boat, they got their nets, and they did what Jesus told them to do. Finally, they sailed into a deeper part of the sea, and Jesus told them to stop there and throw their nets into the water. So they got their nets and they threw inside the water. And Jesus said, "Okay, let's pull the nets and see." And so when the brothers Simon Peter and Andrew, when they pulled the nets by one, two, guess what? Their net was filled with fish. Not just one, not just 10, but they caught lots and lots of fish to the point that their net was tearing apart. It was so heavy. And so finally, Simon Peter and Andrew signaled their partners, the other fishermen, to come and help them. "Come, help us, we have a lot of fish." And so their partners came, and they also helped them to put the nets over. And as they were doing that, because there were so many fish, their boats, both of their boats were sinking. And then that moment, something clicked into Simon Peter's mind. And this is what he said. In Luke chapter 5, verse 8, this is what he said. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, "Go away from me, Lord. I am a sinful man." See, Simon Peter realized that Jesus was not an ordinary man. There was something special about him. And this is what Jesus said. Jesus said, "Don't be afraid. From now on, you will catch men." And then Jesus said, "Come, follow me," right? As soon as Jesus told the brothers to come, follow me, guess what? Simon Peter and Andrew, they didn't think twice, but they left everything and they follow Jesus. See, you guys, just like these disciples, we are also called to follow Jesus. We are also called to become disciples of Jesus. When Jesus calls us, we can't be like, Jesus, wait, give me 5 minutes. Let me go tell my parents. Wait, Jesus, give me 10 minutes. Let me go ahead and grab some money. Wait, Jesus, give me 1 hour. Let me play one round of game. We can't do that, you guys. When Jesus calls, we have to let go. We have to drop and just simply follow Jesus. You guys, Jesus did not need our help to fulfill his mission. But he called Peter, Simon Peter, and Andrew, ordinary people like us, so that we may learn from him. Our big idea is this. Let's read it together in one voice. Ready? Begin. Jesus wants us to follow him. Amen. So you guys, don't forget today's message. Jesus wants us to follow him. Amen? Amen. Let's put our hands together and close our eyes to pray. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you so much for allowing us to share a wonderful story about disciples following after you. God, we want to be your disciples. We want to follow your footsteps. Give us courage, give us faith and wisdom to follow after you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Subscribe! That was a cool video. So what do we do when we like a video? We subscribe. It's like getting to follow a person around so you can see them or learn from them more often. I want to see Baby Shark more often. By the way, did you subscribe to my channel? Of course you did, my friends. Oh, check this out. I have a new video message from a rocking cool friend.
Hi, Callie. I'm learning so much by watching your vlog. I'm so glad Jesus forgives me and knows me. But is there anything I could do for Jesus?
That's a great question, Cadence. Maybe today's Bible story will help us with this one.
It's time for our Bible story. Today, we will learn more about the disciples of Jesus.
Disciples are people who follow Jesus, just like you follow a vlog or watch your favorite show. Disciples were people who watched Jesus with others every single day.
That's right. Once there was a man named Simon Peter. Simon Peter was a fisherman, and fishing was a good job because it gave him money and food.
Really? Did he go on boats and stuff?
Yes, he did. But one day, Simon Peter had been fishing all day, but he didn't catch any fish.
Oh no.
Simon Peter thought he was done fishing for the day, but then Jesus came by. Jesus got onto Simon Peter's boat and told Simon Peter to head out from the shore.
How come?
A lot of people were following Jesus and wanting to hear more of his teachings. Jesus used the boat as a place to teach from.
That's unusual.
Yes, but what was even more unusual is that after Jesus had finished speaking, he told Simon Peter to take the boat into deeper water and put their fishing nets in the water there. Simon Peter told Jesus he already tried that, but he would try again. And when he did, something amazing happened.
What happened?
Simon Peter's net caught so many fish that they had to ask for help from another boat. The nets got so heavy, they began to break, and both boats started to sink.
So Jesus knew where the fishes were?
Exactly. Simon Peter knew right away Jesus wasn't just any other man. Jesus had to be sent from God. Jesus told Simon that instead of fishing fish, he was going to fish for people now.
Do people live in the ocean too?
No, what Jesus meant was that once Simon became Jesus' disciple, he would go with Jesus to tell more people about God. It's kind of like fishing, but instead of using nets, they would use God's word.
Oh, I get it.
Simon Peter left everything and decided to follow Jesus. And so did his brother Andrew and his friends James and John. They followed Jesus from that day on for the rest of their lives.
So, Cadence, I hope that answers your question. Simon Peter and his friends had nothing to give Jesus. Jesus showed them that he was so powerful. He didn't even need anything from them. But there is one thing that Jesus told them to do. And this is something we can do also. Jesus wants us to follow him. Just like we follow those YouTube channels we love or those cool people we see, we can follow Jesus. Jesus doesn't have a vlog we can subscribe to, but when we believe in Jesus and obey the things he teaches us, that's following Jesus. I mean, let's be honest here. Who else is cooler than Jesus? I love being a follower of Jesus, and I hope you follow him too. Speaking of following, friends, thanks again for following this channel and staying tuned to this vlog as we keep growing together. Catch you next time. Peace.
John
chapter 14 verse
6.
아 근데 목사님 그냥 네. 손으로 외우면 너무 재미없잖아요.
맞아요. 맞아요.
뭐 다른 방법이 없을까요?
We need to make some song or some but
special dance.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember Pastor David singing Micah song over and over and
yeah,
over.
Yeah, Micah 7-7 That's
right. Yeah, so a new verse for this month.
That's right. Pastor Joe, we prepared very special song for this month.
Yes.
And the dance.
Ooh. Oh, it's so fun and exciting.
You will like it.
Yes.
Okay, you guys are ready? Set.
Go!
Come on, big word. John 14, verse 6. Yeah, yeah. Jesus answered.
I am the way.
John 14 verse through me.